We came here, we knew it's a track, it's a high downforce track, so it was going to help us a little bit, but not having any data from last year, you know, we come here just rolling out of the truck with the guess, and we kind of guessed a little wrong, and we've been working hard to improve it, and we made a big step for qualifying. Stefan and Sebastian are still working and have their, you know, their more, they needed more track time, so he used the qualifying as a test session. He'll think about it, not look at his data and make changes for the race, and I think we'll be competitive. I mean, we were closer. I was able to do a 22.9 that I improved a lot on my the car and the setup and the thing. But we're still far away. I mean, the window in our car is really small, and we need to. Actually, we didn't even see the window before. Now we got to. Actually, now we find out where the window is, and we start looking for it. But it'll be good. I mean, I think Sebastian and Stefan and Valente will figure out the race, and it's a long race. A lot of things can happen, and we have to push really hard for the podium.
It was such a short weekend with the 1 hour test session, basically half hour, and then the 30 minutes for the Truman session. That, you know, we tried to give it a shot like we did in Road America. We kind of hit and missed on the setup, like Enzo said, to begin with, and it's a very low grip track, and particularly this afternoon when the track got hotter, it was really hot, so we really took the opportunity to run the car with fresh tires, get a new read on the car with significant changes from FP2, and I think it's going to help us figure out something for the race. So a couple of adjustments away from a pretty good race car, I think. We just kind of missed on the tire pressures, so we were really good kind of halfway through the session, and then when everybody kept on improving, we couldn't, which is a bit of a shame, but you know, everybody learns in the team, obviously. It's a fairly new operation, and like Enzo said, when you unload and you have no data from last year, where these guys obviously came and had a race weekend, it's a big disadvantage. So you know, hats off to these guys. They did a very good job for the circumstances, and I think we could have a pretty decent day tomorrow, and for sure we'll have some fast race cars. I think the very last lap I turned here was the lap record in 2007 with the DP01, so it was a little bit of an adjustment. It was something like 18 seconds slower, so yeah, it was a bit weird, but you know, this place is quite awesome, and I haven't always been fast, but when the car is right, I know it's a lot of fun, and that's what we're working towards.
Well, my job is to keep the car clean and straight for my stint, and on the first yellow, you know, after 30 minutes, get out and have Valiente and Stefan close the race, and we'll see what happens. I mean, we need the DP races have been a little crazy in the last couple of rounds, and we just need to keep it clean and keep it there for the end, for the last stint, and the last, you know, after the last yellow, I guess, and have a good car to fight for the end. So I think it'll be okay. We just need to do our job again that we've been doing all season, and like we did at, you know, at Mid-Ohio and at Watkins Glen, and to go back to that podium that we've been missing for the last couple of races, and just keep on learning. I mean, next season, we're looking forward to next season. A lot of changes, a lot of new things coming up, and just excited to, you know, to finish this one and start planning for the next.